27 years. So I think we are going to start with a quick introduction so that I can know who you are, what you do, and what is your expectation. I took advantage of looking at your faces when you are eating, because I knew when we get back here, I'll not be able to see this part well. Let's do a quick introduction. Edith?
My name is Edith. As I mentioned, I'm still employed, and I'm a banker working in Barclays, now I've served for 30 years. And then I left and ran my own consultancy on debt collection, majorly for banks.
Companies that have been in agribusiness. If I can give an example of where I work. During COVID, you people ate a lot of, you used a lot of oils and fats.
Yes,
yeah? Yes. Okay, so thank you very much. Today we are going to look at opportunities that exist in the cultural value chain. You just look at pulses and cereals. Yeah, pulses and cereals is totally different from horticulture, as you see. Now we start by looking at the importance of this sector in our economy. And what is horticulture in the first place? Can somebody tell us what culture is all about? Athanas?
What is horticulture?
Yeah, put it in layman's terms. You still get it. Vegetables, what else? Fruits and vegetables, flowers, that is floriculture. Then we have herbs and spices, which we'll be covering later, and fruits. And this is a very key sector in our economy, because horticulture provides, it contributes to the agricultural GDP by about 33 to 36%. It also employs a lot of people in Kenya, directly about 6 million and about 3.5 million people who benefit directly, indirectly from this sector. It also contributes to food security and nutrition status of this country.